Good morning, Amendra. Today we'll start with the topic evolution. Already we have discussed certain things related to the evolution. Already you know evolution means to roll out or uncover or reveal or unfold. So these are the other terms related to the evolution. In this evolution, we have discussed that changes. That occur. Changes that occur in the flora and fauna of during a period of time. Is called evolution. So these are the terms we have discussed. This is the most important one mark definition for the evolution. So most of the times they will ask the definition and need point of view also they will ask this particular question. Now coming on to the theories supporting the evolution. When we talk about the theories that are supporting the evolution, we have discussed that generally if you want to understand what is evolution, looking back into past, in present is called evolution. That is, unfolding the secrets of past in the present is called evolution. So, in this particular scenario, they have given the stars because star emits the light and that is calculated in terms of light year. The concern with the light year. So here, what are the conditions of the primitive earth?
Ultimate.
20 billion years ago, according to the Big Bang theory, this is the only theory which is explaining. This is the only theory which is explaining about the formation of universe. And approximately 4.5 billion years ago, the Earth was formed from this Big Bang theory only. But later, that is 4 billion years ago, the life started existing on this Earth surface. And 3.2 to 3.8 billion years ago, the first living organism, cyanobacteria emerged on this earth, which is a chemoheterotroph. So these are the some points we have learned about in the previous chapter. Now, coming on to the next one, theories supporting the evolution. Theories supporting the evolution. So, here we have discussed five theories. Theories supporting evolution. So, the theories. Okay, generally we can consider the first theory called as panspermia theory. So when you try to understand this panspermia, spermia means spore. Pan means away from earth. So this panspermia theory was mostly accepted by astronomers, means who are working on the space objects. And the first panspermia theory was put forward by Aristotle. So according to this theory, some object from the outer space which came onto the earth surface and then started giving the life on the earth surface. So this theory may be accepted, may not be accepted, but most of the astronomers still think that that is happening in the nowadays. It has happened, but it has no evidential proof. So we cannot consider the panspermia theory as one of the most efficient evidence for the evolution. Now coming on to this second one, abiogenesis theory. Bio means life, genesis means formation, a means from no life or not having life. So this biogenesis theory itself states that the life formed from non-living objects, life formed from non-living objects or non-life objects or non-living objects, that is non-living material. But it does not give a proper evidence for the evolution. So this theory was also not accepted by the many of the ecologists, evolutionists and other part of the scientists. So this is also not the accepted theory of evolution. The third theory is called as biogenesis theory. The third theory says that formation of life from non-living, that is dead or decaying matter. So it is proved up to some extent, but it was not accepted by the, how it does not, the main flaw or the main limitation of this theory is it was unable to explain how the first life formed on the earth surface. So up to certain extent this was accepted, but it was not completely accepted. The fourth theory is called as spontaneous generation theory. Spontaneous generation theory. According to this spontaneous generation theory, formation of life continuously from the A. So here spontaneously the life is forming continuously from the living objects, and this theory was disapproved, means not accepted, disapproved by Louis Pasteur by doing an experiment in a swan neck experiment. So the theory spontaneous generation, continuous generation was disapproved by Louis Pasteur. So we'll try to understand. And the fifth one, most important one, chemical evolution theory. Chemical evolution theory or organic synthetic evolution theory. Organic synthetic evolution. This theory was worldwide accepted. This theory was worldwide accepted, and the put forward of this theory was done by Hopari and Haldaning. Hopparin and Haldaning. So this theory was also called as Hopparin and Haldaning theory of evolution, or chemical evolution, or organic evolution. So when we try to understand the Louis Pasteur, Louis Pasteur is considered to be the father of immunology, or father of immunology, and he has also done many experiments related to the microbiology, and he is also the inventor of rabies vaccine. You all know these particular things, but Louis Pasteur has done some effort towards the process of evolution. In this, he has taken three Swan-Neck experiment. The experiment is known as Swan-Neck experiment. In this Swan-Neck experiment, he has taken, the first point is, the experiment name is Swan-Neck experiment. He has taken flask of Swan-Neck. These Swan-Neck were having the these are pre-sterilized means, it is a process of disinfecting or removing the microorganisms which cause the damage. So that is called as sterilization technique, or pre-sterilized means which are already sterilized, or generally nowadays we can use as disinfection, means infection causing microorganisms are removed. And in this he has taken broth. So here sugar broth means sugar solution was taken, and this sugar solution was added with yeast, you know, which is generally called as unicellular fungi, Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Saccharomyces cerevisiae was added. The Saccharomyces cerevisiae undergoes fermentation process. Fermentation means, if you want to say here, in the absence of oxygen, microorganism convert the sugar solution into alcohol. So this is aerobic condition. So here fermentation is a process where the absence of air, the sugar solution or molasses is converted into alcohol. Undergoes fermentation and produces, after fermentation, it produces alcohol, ethanol, butanol, propanol, and so on. Generally ethyl alcohol. So, the end product of this experiment is alcohol is produced or not? Is produced in the experiment or not? Alcohol is produced or not? If alcohol is produced, the yeast cells are present. So, in this Svanek experiment, why has taken Svanek means, here if you take this particular, the chances of infection to this contents is comparatively low when compared to the open bottom flask. So in these two Svaneks, so two Svaneks were come there, and in this one, these are pre-sterilized, sugar solution was present. In this also sugar solution was added to both of them, yeast was also added. Yeast was added, and to this again these two were sterilized. Now, so in both of them, yeast cells died because of sterilization process. Yeast died. Once the yeast is dyed, one was completely closed with silver foil and cotton, and this was open to air, and after 3 days, he has observed that opened the boat and he has smelled presence of alcohol in this, and no alcohol was produced. So out of his observation for several experiments like this, he has come to a conclusion that, so if any organism is exposed to air, so the microorganisms enter and start the process, but the spontaneous generation does not. This theory, this experiment was absolutely to prove that spontaneous generation means when the conditions are favorable, only spontaneous generation is occurring, but when the conditions are not favorable for the microorganisms, spontaneous generation theory was disapproved. Spontaneous generation theory was approved based on the killing of yeast, and whether the production of alcohol is occurring in that or not. If alcohol is produced, that alcohol which is produced is only happening when it is open to air, and if spontaneous generation has occurred, it should also occur in the closed flask. So if it is not occurring in the closed flask, that indicates that it is spontaneous generation is not happening. When it is in contact with a certain surface only, it will happen. So this spontaneous generation theory was disapproved in the case of and So all the previous four discussed factors were to be proved as almost wrong, but only the chemical evolution theory was absolutely tried to explain the process of evolution. The process of evolution was most probably explained by the chemical evolution. Have a look to this. So the first form of life, so the chemical evolution theory or organic synthetic evolution. Organic synthetic evolution theory. So this particular theory was put forward by Oparin of Russia and J.B.S. Haldane. J.B.S. Haldane of England. These two proposed the theory called as organic evolution theory or chemical evolution theory. So, according to this theory, they first hypothesized that or first predicted that first form of life formed on the earth surface was from non-living materials. So what can be these non-living materials? So that can be RNA, means ribonucleic acid, or ribonucleic acid, or proteins, or polysaccharides. Polysaccharides. So this was occurred in the year 1920. In the year 1953, a research associate, Stanley L. Miller, and his student, Harold C. Urey, they conducted the experiment by name Stanley Miller experiment. Harold C. Urey has constructed an apparatus called as Stanley Miller apparatus. So according to in this apparatus, they have created the primitive earth conditions. Primitive means the conditions which has existed. Primitive earth conditions. The primitive earth conditions were thunderstorms, volcanic eruptions high temperature and other conditions. So you can say that how the thunderstorms are created. So these are the primitive earth conditions were created. Thunderstorms by the electric discharge. Volcanic eruptions like conditions are the boiling of water. Boiling of water, sea water, and also high temperature is because of boiling of water at high temperature conditions. The high temperature conditions are 400 degrees to 800 degrees centigrade temperatures. So, based by constructing these experiment, these particular phenomena, they have come to a conclusion. They have come to a conclusion that they will be the they have produced the from the prebiotic soup amino acids. So this amino acids form has given the proof that life is formed from the sea. In a similar way, many other scientists have done and have started producing the nucleic acids. Similar, some has given glucose, some other type of components were produced, but the most efficient was the production of the amino acids by the Stanley Miller experiment. So this is a very important 2-mark question which can come in 3 marks sometimes along with the diagram or with explanation for 5 marks. So this is most important diagram in the case of evolution, which was a 2020 5-mark question. In the 2020 second PUC it came for 5 marks. It came for the 5 marks.